And now Alan's been out and about with a film crew asking people what they know about metrication.
You work here on a food store. Do you know when Britain's going to go metric?
No, I don't. The same as that.
What do you know about the metric system? For instance, can I ask you something? No, you're not allowed to look.
No.
how long is a centimetre?
I couldn't tell you. I don't know nothing about it, is it?
How many centimetres to an inch?
I don't know.
No, I couldn't tell you that. I'm 70 years of age. I'm getting beyond.
You're
that.
Lovely for 70.
Oh, thank you.
100?
There's only 2.5, actually, so if you buy centimetres worth of material, you're not going to get as much as you think. What about in liquids? Do you know what a millilitre is?
No idea.
No. No, I don't.
Oh, I don't know.
Do you know how many litres there are in a pint, or how many pints there are in a litre?
Well, all I know is it's bigger than a pint.
About 2.5.
1¾. No. How much does a kilogram weigh?
A kilogram.
I don't know nothing.
Not at all.
I'd say about 12 pounds.
What do you know about the metric system?
I don't want to know.
Well, what I'm doing, I'm packing up my shop.
Really? It's drastic,
yes,
isn't
it? Because we've had the value-added tax, now the decimalisation, first of all, value-added tax, and now they want us to go into the do the same as the common market.
Are there any questions you would like to know about metrication?
Well, I would hope that when it eventually comes, that we will get the same kind of information we got when we went decimal.
Well, after that, you're probably wondering what metrication is. It's the metric system of measuring weight, liquid, length and temperature, which we'll be using in this country by the end of 1975, believe it or not. Metric weights and measures go up and down by 10 and are much easier to calculate than our old system. Let's take a quick look at some of our everyday metric measurements. Weight is measured in kilograms. A kilogram is just under 2¼ pounds. Instead of a pound of butter, you'll probably be buying 500 grams, or half a kilo. Bottled beer, and indeed all liquids, will be sold in litres. So when you go down to the local for your pint, you get just over half a litre. You may have noticed that tins of paint are now only sold in litres and millilitres. So if you want to buy roughly a pint of paint, they'll sell you a tin which contains 500 millilitres, or half a litre. All clothing will be sold in metres and centimetres, the metric measurement for length. This lady's vital statistics are 37, 22, 35. A metre is 3 feet, 3 inches. Already, many tape measures are printed with the new measurements, as well as the old. Distance will be measured in kilometres. A kilometre is 1,000 metres, about 5/8 of a mile. And finally, temperature. This is measured in centigrade. Freezing point is 0 degrees centigrade. A warm summer's day is 20 degrees centigrade. The normal body temperature is 37, and water boils at 100 degrees centigrade. Well, last month, the Consumer Safeguards Group published this report about metrication. They explain the problems to be faced in the changeover, and here to answer our questions about the changeover is Baroness White, Vice Chairman of the Metrication Board.
Lady White, when I went and made that film, I really didn't cook it. I didn't just get people who didn't know. People didn't know. Now, we know metrication is going to take place by the end of 1975, but over what period of time are people going to be taught about it or told about it?
Well, we've been talking to industry and advertising to industry up to now, but the time is rapidly coming when we shall have to turn to the consumer, because we're anxious to help the consumer in every possible way.
I think they need your help, don't you?
I think they probably do. Ultimately, of course, it will be very much simpler, because if you have metric measurements which go in tens and decimal currency which goes in tens, then you'll be able to calculate far more easily than you can in our present measures of weight, length and so on.
Lady White, I accept that it's going to be easier, but what bothers me and a lot of housewives is there's going to be no M day like there was a D day for decimalisation. Why?
Because when you were dealing with decimalisation, you were really dealing with one commodity only, currency, money.
Mm.
And therefore you could do it all on one day. But you see, if you're dealing with metric measurements, you're having to cover the whole range. I mean, everything we buy, everything we use, they differ. Some need to have machinery modifications, some need to have packaging modifications. For some things you have to have your scales adjusted and so on. You really couldn't possibly do it all on one day.
Yeah, but what happens in the high street, for instance, if there are two butchers, one is metric, one isn't? How do we cope?
What we are going to try to do is to see that, as far as possible, that situation doesn't arise, or if it does, it won't last too long. That's going to need a great deal of organising and persuading, and that will be one of the jobs of the Metrication Board.
One of the people in that film that I made said that, you know, he's just going to have to close up his shop because decimalisation did enough damage. People are really frightened. What can you do to allay these fears?
I don't think they need be frightened, because we've gone metric already in many respects. You see, nearly all the building industries are now metric. A great deal of engineering is metric. To bring it closer home, do-it-yourself shops are metric. All the cosmetics that we buy, all the medicines that we buy, they've been metric for a very long time now.
What control do you think you'll have, though, over, say, unscrupulous traders who do try and con the public?
I think our best protection will be to tell the public as carefully and clearly as we possibly can just what is happening. For example, if you're going to buy something as a kilogram instead of £2, take sugar as a simple example, you're going to get 10% more in your new sugar pack than you had in the old one. And as long as it's clearly marked with a metric mark, which is a symbol that we're also going to do something about, and you know what you're doing, then you would expect that the price would be a little bit more, 10% more. You shouldn't be conned if you really know the facts.
What things are going to go metric in what order? In other words, what should we look out for over the next few months? What's going to go metric?
Well, the things which are going to go metric, perhaps not in the next few months, but certainly next year, will be clothing. You find that children's clothing particularly are now very often dual-marked in
yes,
both metric and the
that.
Present
yeah.
things. Now, women's clothing, I think, are going to be quite simple because we'll still have, you know, the 12, 14, 16, 18, and you'll still go for that.
You mentioned children just now. Sorry, could I just break in here because we've only got a short time. Most children, I'm told, are being taught, and yet my own too. I questioned very closely this morning about metrication. They said, what's that? And I said, well, it's kilos and metres. Are children really being taught, or is it when they're 15 and 16?
No, I don't know what sort of school your children go to, but most primary schools in the country are now teaching in metric. And as from this year, the public exams, you know, O-levels, A-levels, CSE and all that, the papers have been set in metric.
So you're confident that we will go over to the metric system very easily?
I don't think the children will have the slightest difficulty.